We shall now add the database for our project. We shall add the entity framework classes also. So let us have a look at our database structure and the various tables that we'll be using in our project. To our Solution Explorer, we have added a database called dborders.sdf. We are using SQL Server Compact database. We could have used SQL Server also. It is a matter of connection string only. Since SDF will simplify and ease our things, we have preferred this one. Let us have a look at the various tables that are included in the database. This is the database. There is a table for orders or invoices and a table for TBL products that stores a list of products that are available for sale, and TBL users is the collection, is the table for the customers in this project. Let us start by having a look at TBL products. TBL products has two columns, product code and product name, and the structure is like this. Product code is NCHAR1, it's the primary key. Product name is NVARCHAR, its length is 100 and it is not the primary key, but it stores the data. Product name, and what is the sample data that we have included is product code is S, product name is software, product code is M, product name is mobile, product code is L, product name is laptop. So this company is selling products of only three types, and when an invoice is generated, the product type is product code is one of the foreign keys into TBL orders. Let us also have a look at the TBL users. TBL users has four columns. One is auto numbered primary key. It will auto increment identity column. The customer email, customer name and customer phone, just normal data columns used for storing information about a customer. We can have a look at the structure of this table. So in case you are following this lecture, you can use this information to create your own database. Customer email NVARCHAR 50, customer name NVARCHAR 100, customer phone NVARCHAR 15, ID auto primary key, and if you look here, it is an identity column, increment is 1 and seed is 1, so as new records are added, it will automatically increment. Primary key, yes, ID auto PK is the primary key, and this table is not optimized, it's just for training purposes. It is not optimized. For example, customer email or customer phone, this could be a little bit shorter also or longer also depending on the needs. Now I'll show you the data that we have already included. Customer email, customer name, customer phone, ID auto primary key, some sample data has already been included here. You can also include this. Then we will come to table TBL orders. In this table we are having one is again ID auto primary key. customer foreign key. So this will be a foreign key coming from TBL users. Product foreign key will be coming from TBL products. Then invoice amount and order date. So this is going to be a structure like this. This is your TBL orders. This is your TBL products. And this is your TBL users, and you are having one to many story coming here. We can also have a look at the sample data that we have already included in TBL orders. Just any MS and all those codes. Customer 1, 3, 5, their foreign keys. And it's a structure. In this case, ID auto primary key. This is the primary key. Customer foreign key. It's int because you have ID auto primary key there, which is auto incrementing number. So foreign key is also data type must match. Product code is NCAR1. There also the primary key is NCAR1. Invoice amount is a small int and order date is a date time. In this case, is identity. And order date is probably get date. So it will always be the current date time. No default has been added to other values. So there is a default on ID auto PK and order date. Then we can have a look at the formal relationships that manage relations, because we have already added. We have two relations. One is the foreign key for the product code. Primary is TBL products. Foreign key table is TBL orders. And update rule is cascade, delete cascade. Product code is a foreign key into product code FK. Similarly, for the other table users, ID auto primary key is a foreign key as customer FK. Primary key, foreign key, update rule, delete rule, that all you can see. So you can add all the relations through the designer also. Like we go to add relations. For details, you can refer to earlier videos in which I have explained completely how these relations are added and all. So I'm not repeating it here. Okay, our next step is going to be to add the idiom classes. For this, I'll do one thing: close all documents, come to Solution Explorer, fold the tree. So this is what I see here. I'll add a new folder, add folder, and give it a name, entity models. And here I'll right click and add ADO.NET entity data model. Here you can, or you could have gone to add new item, found the same thing. I'll give it a name. I'll give it a name mod orders and click OK. To follow the usual steps, next. I'm not explaining the whole thing here because we have already given detailed lectures earlier. Finish. And if everything goes well, this is what we should get: TBL product, TBL order and TBL user a relationship. You can save it, and in our solution explorer we'll have all those mod orders.edmx, those DTs and EDMX diagram classes. So this completes our this lecture. In the next lecture we'll talk about adding the MD classes so that validation is also built in right from the start.